we went to go see a movie on Friday, and I was excited as fuck, man. We went to go.
Why?
I don't know why, man. I don't know why. We went to go see Nine Lives on Friday, and I went in that theater happy as fuck. Look at that. I took a selfie. I went in there chanting, Nine Lives, Nine Lives, Nine Lives. Well, I was. That's the movie. That's the that cat movie. With Kevin Kevin Spacey.
It's that Kevin Spacey cat movie.
That Kevin Spacey cat movie. And here's the thing, y'all. Before we start.
Oh, you got to take a drink?
Let me tell you. I got to. I know there's no drinking rule on this show right here. But I
made up by somebody. I don't remember.
Some asshole institute had a rule.
But I gotta take this drink right here so I can just not hold back on this creamy goodness that is Nine Lives.
God.
That better actually be tea.
No,
I'm good, man.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
There's a lot more in there. I might need it.
There won't be in long before long.
If y'all haven't heard, the premise is simple. Kevin Spacey's a cat.
Sure, it's like Freaky Friday, right?
Something like that. Kevin Spacey, that old story of, you know, the rich corporate dude out there, all about that money. No, but you know, family, that's second right there. You know, I can't take care of family if I ain't got that money. And he's trying to build the tallest building in America, too.
This is all legit, the premise. Yeah. This is like the first 10 minutes.
Jennifer Garner is his wife, and she's like, your child, she needs you. Bitch, I'm trying to make the tallest building in the world. Don't you see what I'm trying to do here?
Yeah, I can make another child.
Yeah,
easily.
Yeah.
She's not going to be that tall anyway.
Yeah, exactly. She'll never be as tall as this glorious shit right here.
Oh, I got children all over this city. I ain't worried about it.
Yeah, fuck it. I'll make another. But he goes into a shop to get a last-minute birthday gift for his daughter, and that's when the great Christopher Walken there says, he says, hey, I'm going to do my worst Christopher Walken prayer. Hey, you don't spend time with your family. I don't know what
to say. Christopher Walken turned Italian.
Yeah, when Christopher Walken joined the Godfather?
Today. But he says, I'm going to turn you to a cat so that you learn a lesson.
Wow.
Didn't Eddie Murphy and or Adam Sandler already make this movie?
Oh, Martin, but it's timeless. It's a timeless tale. Learning your lesson by being a talking animal. Let's go ahead and take a look at the trailer, because the trailer can tell you way more than I can right now for this instant classic, Nine Lives.
Tom Brand excelled at business.
The Firebrand Tower will be the tallest building in North America.
But failed at what mattered most.
Hi, Tom.
Yes, I know. I'm late.
You gotta be here, and you have to bring an exceptional gift.
Now a mysterious man.
You look familiar.
I'm Tom Brand. I own Firebrand.
Yes, I use newspaper in the poopy boxes, and I see your face all the time.
It's uncanny how much I sound like him, right? Spot on. Or maybe it's just the tequila talking.
Change everything.
Can I just pick out a cat, and then I'll be on my way?
He likes you.
Yeah, keep the change.
Okay, Cass.
I'm sorry?
Let's do this.
What is on you?
So, what are you doing in there?
Wait a minute. I'm a cat!
You have 1 week to reconnect with them, or you're gonna be stuck inside that cat for the rest of your life.
But I hate cats!
That's what makes this so perfect.
Sometimes I feel like my dad's looking out for me through the cat.
I should have been a better dad.
Do they make MRIs for cats?
You mean CAT scans?
That cat is so weird.
Gotta show them I'm human.
Honestly, when I thought about going, I remembered that scene of the cat doing chin-ups, and I just couldn't bring myself to do it.
Oh, man, Martin, you missed out, bro.
All right, just tell me this. Like, it'll give it points for me. If you tell me that Christopher Walken is the same character he was in Click.
No, he was not.
No.
Damn, it's very similar, but no. Yeah. He's like his brother.
Yeah.
I mean, like if they tied him together.
No, Martin, it's not going to happen, Martin. Anyway, hold on, y'all.
All right, Andy Cap.
This shit here.
Woo!
I'm gonna start talking like George Orwell. I'm the best at everything in the world.
It's fucking cat race. It's. Let me tell you something. This is not real. This shit is not. I refuse to believe that any of this bullshit is real. Kevin Spacey, actor trained at Juilliard, is in a movie that this Nine Lives. This is not. This is a. This he owes somebody money. He's in trouble with the mafia. He owes on taxes. This is a bet. This is a dare. But this is not a real movie.
It's kind of an asshole move on his part, because that's the kind of role that usually goes to an actor who's way washed up.
Martin, let me tell you something. This,
and
this
he took
this,
it from
Martin. This is not. This is not real. This is a joke. Next week, we're going to have a aha moment. I got you. This is a social experiment. But this is not a real fucking movie. This is. I refuse to believe this. This is the world's world record setting troll right here. Something is behind this. This is not real. This is Kevin Spacey, classically trained actor, who... For what it's worth, this has some misfires, but nothing like this. This is him doing bad readovers on a fucking cat. I mean, the reading is bad because you could tell that he did this later when he had nothing to react to or to talk to.
You
nailed it. This
Kevin Spacey, man. This is somebody that if this is true. Then this man is in trouble. Who has members of your family in a basement somewhere, Kevin? Talk to us, man. Because unless that is the case, this is not real. The only other person to have it worse than Kevin Spacey in this movie is that fucking cat. There's a cat in this movie, and I don't know that cat's name. I don't know where they got that cat from or where he's hired from or who his agent is, but this cat spends the time, most of the time, being a real cat. And then the script requires that this animal does some of the most degrading bullshit. And this cat, I can imagine this cat even telling them, look, I'm not doing this shit.
I have standards. Yeah.
Do what you want to with me. I'm not doing this shit. I got a career to think about. So they said, all right, fine, fuck you. You know what we're going to do? We're gonna do a CGI stunt cat, and it looks like a piece of shit. they have...
I so wish you would have went and saw this.
Man, I do too.
The cat moves all weird. They like it was almost like they were, okay, you want to do this shit? We're going to fuck your career up. Yeah. This cat turns into like this fucking weird Muppet. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Like that fur turns into Muppet fur all of a sudden.
That whole scene of that cat trying to open a liquor bottle.
That's...
Oh, yeah. They know this movie should be a drinking game.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of drinking in this movie.
Oh, yeah.
An obscene amount of drinking for a kid's movie.
Yes.
That's the thing about it. It's funny because for a children's film, alcoholism, that's comedy gold to them.
Oh yeah. Oh, yeah.
They actually refer to alcoholism as funny. The cat is an alcoholic.
He's an alcoholic. I can't get him to eat, but I found an empty decanter of 50-year-old Macallan with fur all over it.
They tell you straight up, the cat's an alcoholic. If the cat ain't drinking, Kevin Spacey's ex-wife is drinking.
Come on, help me out before your hands get all shaky. This is for the road.
DTs is fucking funny. Yeah,
our kids are watching it. My mommy and daddy are like that too.
Yeah, yeah.
I can't relate.
If the characters aren't playing drunk, they really are drunk on the set. You can't tell me that Christopher Walken wasn't drunk when he's doing these lines. Yeah.
I use newspaper in the poopy boxes, and I see your face all the time.
His tryout for the Riddler was basically in this.
Yeah. And his ass looking more like Bram Stoker's Dracula and shit.
Oh, yeah.
He's turning into a fucking creature more and more, man. But, and there's a whole scene where this cat, I mean, they use nothing but CGI for a scene where this cat tries to open a bottle of scotch. And the funny thing is, when they do this CG with the cat, like the cat is already moving all weird and shit.
Yeah.
But to add insult to injury, they got a dude who makes the fake cat sounds.
Yeah. It's clearly a man.
You can tell it's just some guy.
It's clearly a dude just going, meow. throughout this whole sequence.
Yeah, so when this cat is trying to do all this, you got some dude off you know, off camera on the mic. He turns into Scooby-Doo for a while. It's one of the most embarrassing things that I've seen for a non-human actor.
Non-living actor. That cat's basically mostly CGI in this movie.
Yeah.
When Garfield looks better.
Hey, Luca. Is that a new chain you're wearing, fella? Looks good on you.
When that shit looks better than what's supposed to be a real cat.
Hey, man, but that's Bill Murray, too. Maybe it's something like these cat movies where people come in.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe it's some cat conspiracy out there.
Yeah. It's in your SAG contract that you have to do cat movies.
Yeah. Oh, I guess so.
You know, nobody reads the fine print.
Yeah. You'll see Tom Hanks in a cat movie soon enough.
Flying an airplane.
Tom Hanks in Mission Impossible 5 driving a car and shit. No! Tom Hanks, no!
Mama always said.
That's a Mission Impossible 5, man. Right
there. You got a sneak peek.
Yeah, that's the next Taken movie. Right there. You know, that cat should have been a hand puppet. It looked so bad.
That might have been worse, man. Yeah. How cracked out that cat would be, like the eyes would be going this way. Well,
I guess then it would be them saying, like, look, we know it's a joke. You're in on it, you know, a big wink. This way you go like, wait, are you guys serious? Or are you not serious? What's going on here?
Well, you can tell from like the 1999 level of CGI in this movie that they didn't know if they were going to be serious or not and put money into this. Mm-hmm. That's what I think about it.
No, you're right. This is...
But they spent plenty of money advertising it. That's what's weird.
They spent a little bit, not a whole lot. This is going to be dumped from the beginning. As if these actors weren't bad enough. This is Barry Sonnenfeld. Sonnenfeld, who did Man in Black. I mean, he's done big blockbuster films.
Adam's Family.
And this kind of shows on this... It's slick, but it has an overuse of green screen.
Oh, my God.
So that
the opening shot is a terrible green screen shot.
So, it's like, for no reason. It's like, he said, y'all making me do a fucking cat movie. He tries to do the best he can with it. There's so many shots like this where they zoom in on things for nothing just to show people that he has a little bit of money. But it's also, you know, the other thing is it's also kind of colorful. So it's you can tell they shoot it with a high grade of video.
Yeah, the saturation was out of control.
Yeah, so when you watch the digital, it's turned up, man.
Yeah.
So it's colorful, but it's oversaturated.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it looks like a really high end, but still straight to Blu-ray or home video type of movie.
Yeah.
And you know when I see a movie like this where they have an old theme, that's one thing to remake something where old theme. Tried and true. You know, we remake things in Hollywood all the time. But the shit didn't work back then. This is a 1959 movie that is based on called The Shaggy Dog.
Yeah, I remember that.
You remember that movie?
Yeah, I remember watching it on the Wide World of Disney. I think they made a sequel also, but I know they did a remake of it later.
Oh, they did a remake in 2006 with Tim Allen.
You have to connect with the whole family again.
But an unlikely visitor.
You're so cute.
There's a dog in the kitchen.
With an unbelievable power. Is about to change his life in ways he never...
So he got dog sperm up in his system and they turned into a fucking...
Bite him and give him like a venom symbiote?
Yeah, look at this.
Whoa.
Turns into a fucking were dog, you know?
Yeah.
And guess what? The shit didn't work back then. Barely worked in 1959. So now they're thinking, well, shit, it didn't work with dogs, but cats. Ah, that's the secret right there.
Untapped market.
This
song is a whole lot of thinking going on. Like, no real strategy here.
Man, this is, listen, it's one of those movies, the only thing that saves this, and this is the most backhanded compliment that I can give it. It is so shitty that I did have a good time. Everything I was cheering for this movie to be when I was walking in, Nine Lives, this shit was it.
It delivered it more.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we weren't the only ones. No bullshitting. Y'all can back me up on this. I walked in, and there was this old Mexican dude. Looked to be like close to 70. In there watching Nine Lives at night by himself. I thought he had grandkids. He was by himself.
Yeah.
And he got a phone call, and he answered that shit. And we heard him out in the lobby. Like, he went down like, what are you doing? You interrupted my talking cat movie.
I've waited for months.
I waited for months. Call me tomorrow. You're ruining my talking cat experience. Was that my line?
No.
Dude was fucking mad.
Yeah, he was mad that someone had the temerity to interrupt his viewing experience of 9 fucking lives. It was amazing.
I was, man, and kids were in there talking. People were just having a good time. No, people, this movie is such bullshit. People don't even try to be polite to each other or the film.
Yeah, man. We talked the whole way through it. Nobody cared.
Yeah.
How many people were in there?
10, maybe?
Yeah, about 10. Yeah. Man, I wish I could pick it up. Like, in the middle of the movie, Corey Goodwin, he's taking selfies of us.
We here. Yeah, we're here. All you see is us, and there's a whole bunch of empty seats.
Yeah. We like started from the bottom. Now we're here.
We made it.
Man. But yeah, man, this is yeah. I'm gonna let y'all give y'all's opinion. Then I guess I'll give my ratings. Go ahead. What you got?
Oh, it's yeah. It plays out like a fever dream. You can't really believe that it's real. Like there's just so many moments that. I laughed my ass off in this all throughout, like, for all the wrong reasons. It, like, yeah, the colors in it, just looking at it, is an ugly, cheaply made sack of shit movie that just made me smile throughout the whole goddamn thing. So
I felt like I took my child to a movie. You were sitting next to us and just laughing. Like, man, this
it is funny.
Yeah, at that seal left. me and Miss Mia looked at each other like he was our child. We're like, she was like, he's so happy, baby.
Yeah. Well, like just when the productions company name came up, you and I, Goodwin, we started laughing at that. When the productions, their production company's name pops up, and this shitty like green screen effect of the cat's head popping out like through the yoga, just goes, and that was like, we're in it.
And did that shit in slow motion too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's strap ourselves in.
Shit, Mia, you had a good time with this too, didn't you?
Yes.
She was like, when we were going, she was like, count me in.
I was
going
to ask you why you took her for her birthday, but I got my aunt.
Nine lives. Yeah. That's all she needed.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's my baby's birthday over there. Did we go to a fancy dinner? Did I take her to a romantic picnic or some event? No, we watched a fucking talking cat movie together, and she was happy for it.
Make it a tradition.
Yeah. But, yeah, Mr. Goodwin, sir.
Man, I'm sorry. I had... This movie reminded me of all those old Disney movies that you know are bad.
Sure.
But you still like them. Like, for me, I came out of it, I was like, man, this is kind of like Heavyweights for me. Like, Heavyweights, it's not a great movie. Like, because I've gone back and watched it.
Fans out there, somebody said,
yeah! Everybody's like, yeah, I love Heavyweights! It's one of those movies where, like, Disney would put it out and say, nah, this is Buena Vista. This is not us.
Sure.
Yeah. It's the one, and this is what caught me about it, because there are glimpses of great acting moments in here. Like Kevin Spacey, he channels a House of Cards moment in like the first 15 minutes.
Yeah,
of this.
He does.
And you're like, holy shit, like he's putting his all into this. And then he turns into that cat and it goes insane. It goes off the wall. Christopher Walken's in here in a daze, like you said, he looks drunk. And Jennifer Garner, I don't even know, like majority of her shots in this movie were her lying in bed.
Yeah, there was a lot of her
spooning with her daughter and shit. Yeah.
Weird, man. But it's one of those, it's a beautiful train wreck, and I'm so happy that I went and saw this. I really wish you were there, man. You need to see this. I encourage everybody to go out and see this.
Man, watch.
Oh, so full price.
Well, we got to go around. Yeah. Let them go.
The only thing that could be better than this movie, even though it's bad, I had a great time. The only thing that could be better than this fucking film right here is the documentary that's going to come out 5 years from now explaining why the fuck this exists. Mm-hmm. Why this happened. Because I still refuse to believe that this is on the straight and narrow right here. There's some dubious shit going on.
Tell you, somebody saw Kevin Spacey murder somebody in real life. Like that scene from the House of Cards is not
train.
I saw that.
Yeah.
Here's my script.
It was Barry Sonnenfeld. It was yeah, I got you.
My master. Somebody saw Kevin Spacey fucking a cat and blackmailed him. There's something. A soul was sold to Satan. Something happened with this fucking film. I don't know what it is. Mm-hmm. It's bullshit. Look, it's bullshit. But it's the
Are
best.
Are you sure?
Martin, but if possible, it's the best piece of bullshit I've ever had.
So it'll be this year's best worst movie.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's identical of this year.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm telling you, you stoners out there, you alcoholics, you know, you people who are recovering drug addicts, go stay.
He's not wrong, though. The first thing we said when that movie was done and we all stood up, he's like, damn, I wish I would have been drunk for this.
I'm telling you, if you feel like you're about to fall off the wagon, no, don't go see this shit. You'll be drinking. I'll go recommend you see this. But everybody else, man, if you take it in the right way, it is bullshit. You got to have a good time. I don't know what it is. I had a better time in this than I did in Suicide Squad, man. I'm just being honest.
That's something else we said right after, too.
I got to be fucking honest.
Y'all just trolling people now.
No, like, being serious. We had a great time watching this movie. Like, majority of Suicide Squad, I was just, all right, what's happening? And this one is like, all right, what's happening?
It's a difference when a movie tries to sell you some dumb shit and act like it's smart.
Yeah.
But when a movie tries to tell you that, yeah, we know it's a fucking talking cat and we know it's stupid. When a movie ain't trying to have no pretense about that, you got to give it a little bit of credit for that. Just a little bit. You know, I'm not recommending you go see it. But if you just happen to trip and fall and you wake up and see a talking cat on the screen.
It's a Saw torture trap. Look forward to the game.
Yeah.
That happened to me last week.
Yeah. So did y'all give y'all's rating?
No, go for it, Gert.
I was hoping that I would I would pop my double-toasted movie reviewing cherry with a Boo, a Madea Halloween, but I'll be goddamn if this isn't a good consolation prize. Because holy crap. I can't in good conscience give this thing anything better than a some old bullshit. But it's that lightning in a bottle, some old bullshit. It's a drinking game just waiting to happen. It's fun, but it's terrible. And if you want to see one of those movies that's just so bad that's gonna make you laugh your ass off, this is it, dude.
Oh, yeah. This shit right here.
Yeah.
Corey Goodwin.
And you say in good conscience, and both of you gave it a some old bullshit, like you say you can't give it anything better than that. I disagree. I disagree. This was one of those movies that it just went so bad that it came back to being good. It went up just a level. It's not a full price or a matinee. For me, it's a rental. Okay. I think you should go, whenever this comes out on DVD or Blu-ray, buy this shit. Because you're going to, don't rent it. I want you to keep this around in your house where people are like, man, have you seen this movie or this movie? Yeah, but have you seen the Nine Lives? Break out the whiskey or whatever you drink and go for it. You will have a ball watching this. I can't wait to show this to my friends. If people, and I want to put this out there.
You're not going to have too many friends.
Toasties, if you go come into town and you want to watch this, call me. I will go with you. Man, this movie was, I had so much fun with this. And I had a ball.
And you got to keep in mind, that is the stoner review.
You know what I'm saying? You took it to another level.
No,
where I'm like,
man, I had, so, this is like, you said identical, like people should see that.
Yeah.
They've got to see Nine Lives. They've got to.
Mm-hmm. Now, keep in mind, Corey's right. This is the stoner review. Y'all can sit down and watch this along with a double feature of a talking cat.
You can talk, but only once.
I don't make the rules.
I got like, what the fuck? That's the worst CG I've ever seen.
Until you saw Nine Lives.
What is that?
That's on Netflix.
Oh, you haven't seen
cat?
That?
Oh. A talking cat. You haven't seen this shit
it's
before?
It's a cinematic classic, man.
Yeah, somehow I managed to miss this.
Yeah, Martin.
You can talk, but only once.
I don't make the rules.
Who's the dude that was the bad guy in The Dark Knight?
Oh, it's Eric Roberts.
Eric Roberts is
that sounded like Kevin Spacey just then.
Might have been.
He just put Eric Roberts' name on it. I don't want to be associated with
that. That's Eric Roberts, man, from Batman right there.
And you can hear that reverb. It sounds like he recorded it in a closet.
I'm a talking cat.
Honey, what are you doing there?
Nothing. All his audio is just voicemail.
Yeah. Hey everyone, thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe to our channel and go over to our home, doubletoasted.com, for more videos and live streams. And remember, stay toasty.